We're trying to prove that if A and B are elements of a ring, then A times the additive inverse of B is the additive inverse of A times B. And you really should think in terms of that language in your mind, at least, additive inverse. Not, I mean, yes, you could say negative B, and yes, you could say negative of AB, but these are not necessarily numbers. So does that even make sense? It's better, and it emphasizes the meaning more if you say that's the additive inverse of B and this is the additive inverse of AB. So you're trying to show ultimately that A times negative B is the additive inverse of AB. What does that mean? It means if I add it to AB, I should get 0, right? Because that's what additive inverse means. So in your scratch work, that would be the first thing I attempt to do, is to see if I can show that when I add those, I get 0. And again, you say to yourself, well, I only allow myself to use the definition of a ring. Essentially, that's my axioms. Those are the things that I can assume are true. And I hope one thing that pops out right away looking at this expression is that there's an A on the left in both terms that can be factored out. You're really using the distributive property like this, right? That would be the distributive property. And then B and negative B are additive inverses. So negative B plus B is 0. And hey, that's the thing that we tried to prove with 0 last time. And eventually, with a little bit of looking at the book, we got that it was 0. We can use previous things that we proved. That seems like the essence of the proof, doesn't it? I've shown A times negative B. Okay, yeah, I said negative. A times the additive inverse of B added to AB gives me the additive identity 0. Can I immediately conclude that this is true? Yeah, you basically can. I mean, you're really also using, if you do immediately conclude that, you're also using the fact that that additive inverses in groups are unique. We've shown this plus that is 0 by uniqueness of additive inverses. That means this must be the additive inverse of that. Okay, so now let's write this out nicely. You could say by the distributive property, A times the additive inverse of B plus AB is A times, in parentheses, the additive inverse of B plus B. I'm going to separate this into a couple sentences, as I could have combined this into one sentence. Since the additive inverse of B is, well, okay, I'll say it in words, is the additive inverse of B. Okay, maybe I should say negative B is the additive inverse of B. The additive inverse of B plus B is 0. So this is A times 0. We know by a previous property that's been proved, you could quote what theorem it is in the book. I think it's theorem 12.1, part 1 or something. 12.1. By theorem 12.1, part 1, that A times the additive identity is the additive identity. Therefore, by uniqueness of additive inverses, I'm being maybe a little overkill here, in groups, rings are groups under addition, A times the additive inverse of B must be, in fact, the additive inverse of AB. We're done. Praise the Lord. Is this the way the book does it? I didn't look. Let's see. They're proving rule 2 here. Okay, yeah, they started the same way as us. A times negative B plus AB, factor out the A. And negative B plus B is 0, and we know this is 0. So I was doing maybe a little overkill in the reasoning, but maybe not such a bad idea to do initially here. Okay, then they didn't apply uniqueness of additive inverses. They said adding the additive inverse of AB to both sides yields the conclusion. So they added negative of AB to both sides. On the left, it cancels the AB, simplifying to that. And on the right, zero plus that is that. So just a different style of getting the conclusion.